La coqueta, la coqueta, you know who I am. FIFA 20 defending, I feel like Uncle Sam. Texting all you haters cause you ain't I defend. Call the apps Tekashi cause all they do is bend. Broke boy, elite is what I like to choke boy. I am just a joke boy. Persecutes me, nom nom nom, I'm bok choy. Yeah, yeah, I'm a broke boy. Leave you swimming with the fishes, I am so coy. Opposition looking funny, joke coy. Class session, yeah, take some notes, boy. Broke boy.
What is the deal, YouTube? It is your boy, One Star Week, and we are back for another episode of the Broke Boy Road to Glory in the middle of perhaps the sweatiest weekend league yet. Ultimate team of the season, Red Pit Weekend League. Everybody is sweating their nuts off to try to get these player picks. And yeah, it's been quite a ride so far. First off and foremost, I do have to say thank you to everybody that showed up to the stream yesterday. I think we peaked at about 20 concurrent viewers, and we consistently had 10 to 15 viewers there. We had 40 unique viewers, and the most important thing is we raised $135 for Black Lives Matter. So thank you to everybody that passed by and said hi. I really appreciate it. I will be looking to stream more in the future. So if you want to follow me on Twitch, the link's going to be in the description box down below. So let's get into the episode. We're going to start off by talking about the new SBC's EA drop. So we got 91 Mertens, I think I already talked about him. We got Danny Ings, who looks like a poor man's team of the season, Vardy. He looks like a very good card. And what's really cool about him is that they've upgraded him to four-star. So if you're a Southampton fan, if you're an EPL diehard player, maybe you want to get this card. The one I really want to talk about here is this Luka Modric flashback. I mean, this card looks absolutely insane. He got the high work rates. I actually was going to bring him in for the last 10 games of Weekend League, but I just couldn't fathom how to bring him in on cam. He does link to my Militao and Ramos, but there's just too many leagues in my team. I got Tevez, I got a link. I got Renato Sanchez, Atal, I got a link. It's a complicated situation, but yeah, I do want to review him going forward. Let me know in the comment section down below. Do you want me to review this card? He looks absolutely insane and at a decent value as well. Let's jump into the squad though. So, as you guys know, we are in the middle of the weekend league. If you stopped by the stream yesterday, you'll have known that we left off the stream at 14-6 in pole position to challenge for gold one. And at the end of the episode, you gotta find out if we actually hit gold one. Let's look at some stats though, because stats lie, or stats don't lie. Men lie, women lie, stats don't. I butcher that. But let's talk about the new players here. We got Tevez. And yeah, this card is absolutely nuts. 25 goals, 13 assists in 29 games as our lone striker. We got Atal, who did almost as good as Tevez. I think he did arguably better. 23 goals, 17 assists in 29 games from the cam position in a 4-2-3-1. But the main man we're going to be talking about today is going to be 94 rated team of the season, Salvio. And if you passed by the stream yesterday, this guy was my scapegoat. I was yelling at him. I was talking all kinds of trash about him. But today, in the last day of Weekend League, he came out pretty big. And I really enjoyed this card. But we're going to talk more about him later. He's 5'8". He has high medium work rates. He's right footed with a 4-star combination. I played 29 games in the Weekend League with him at the right cam position. And he got 5 goals and 5 assists. Before we go any further, if you're enjoying the content, if you want more player reviews, do me a favor, hit the like button down below. And if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing to the channel. I appreciate all you guys at home for watching this video. So, we look at this card, man. He looks sick. He looks like the prototypical winger during team of the season. I mean, the pace is there. The finishing is very good. And just to make sure, we got him on the sniper cam style to bring that finishing up to 99, to bring the volleys up to 94, and to bring his penals up to 99. His passing stats look very nice as well. His dribbling is insane. And what's really underrated about this card is his defending and physical. He has 80 strength, 94 stamina. The defending stats are solid. So if you're looking for a wide mid in a 3-5-2, if you're looking for a box-to-box mid in a 4-1-2-1-2, maybe he might fit the bill. Yeah, so let's talk about it. We're gonna jump into the gameplay. I'm gonna let you guys know how I did in the Weekend League, and I'm gonna let you guys know, is Salvio worth it? Let's get it. So this Salvio card is selling for 106,000 coins on the PS4 market, and he's likely to drop after squad battles rewards this evening. Is he worth it? I would have to say absolutely. Don't think twice. If you got Tevez, if you got the Argentinian link, get him on your squad. We're going to break down the stats though, so you know exactly what to expect at home. So, first we're going to talk about his pace. He has 97 pace, and one thing I really noticed about this card is if you really need a winger to run up and down the pitch at lightning quick speed, he got it. He beats the defensive line every single time. His acceleration coming out of skill moves is very nice, and his sprint speed at 94 ensures that once he's in behind, he stays in behind, he's gone, he's done, he's dusted. Overall, his pace has to be a 10 out of 10. Next, we'll talk about shot, and one thing I really noticed is his attack positioning is very good, all right? I was criticizing him when I was on stream because I felt like he was disappearing, but that was just more me and not focusing 100%. When I really focused on the runs this guy was making, he was making very intelligent runs. He was positioning himself very, very nice, and he was always in the right place at the right time. I really enjoyed that. His finish is very reliable. I hit it with his left foot, his right foot. If you get it from a good angle, it's gonna hit the back of the net, and a lot of that has to do with the fact that he has 99 shot power. His shot power is insane. Every shot was like a bullet. So if he's gonna hit that ball somewhere on target, it's gonna test the keeper every single time. One thing he does lack is the important traits. He doesn't have finesse or outside the foot shot trait. So I wouldn't probably play him at the striker position, but at cam, at wide cam, at the wing, I think he's perfect. Overall, this guy's shooting is an 8.75 out of 10. Next, we'll talk about his passing, and I really enjoyed this aspect of his card as well. He definitely has the passing of a cam with the 93 vision, the 94 short passing, the 99 curve. So in and around the box, his tiki, his taka is on point. His long passing is solid as well. I mean, he's not going to be a deep line playmaker, so to say, if that's how you want to employ him as, because his long passing is only 80. But at the same time, he's very reliable, and he's not going to let you down in that regard. His crossing is very good. If you want to hit a low-driven cross, he could do that very accurately. Overall, this guy's passing is an 8.5 out of 10. Next, we'll talk about this dribbling, and I think his dribbling along with his pace is his best attribute. The way he felt on the ball was so smooth. He was so snappy, so reactive, so responsive. He could turn with the best of them. He could twirl, keep spinning with the best of them. His dribbling is 99. His ball control is 98. His composure is also 98. He is one of the most press-resistant wingers I have ever used on this game. So even just the left stick dribbling alone, if you're not a skiller, is enough with this card. His ball control in tight areas is impeccable. And overall, this guy's dribbling is a 9.5 out of 10. He fits the meta so well due to his dribbling. Finally, we will address his defensive contributions and his physical. And it was actually very good having him and Atal forward, because I had the Atal cam, I had Salvio at right cam, made it very difficult for my opponents to get out of their own half. I mean, when I was pressing with these two cards with their pace, their defensive capabilities, as well as their physical, it was really, really nice to have on my team. This guy's tackling is pretty solid. He has 80 strength, 88 aggression, 74 stand tackling, and it definitely makes an impact. Would I play him in a defensive position? No. But if he finds himself in a defensive position, he won't let you down. His 94 stamina ensures he lasts all game, and he has 99 jumping. So if you need somebody to lob the ball to, he's going to be very reliable at winning the header. Overall, this guy's defensive contributions and physical has to be an 8 out of 10. All right, guys, so what's the final verdict on this card? I think this guy is an amazing winger. I think if you need somebody to run up and down the pitch, provide width, this guy's going to be amazing at that. His pace and dribbling are insane. His shooting and positioning are very reliable. And his passing, defensive, and physical contributions are very nice. He has no real weakness aside from the fact that he's difficult to link. And overall, I got to give him a 9 out of 10. I really enjoy this card, and you can't beat the value for money. All right, guys, so you might be wondering how I'm doing in the weekend league or how I did. And I think we did very well. We had to go back to the 4-2-3-1. We had to play a bit like a rat this weekend. And this is the last weekend I'm doing it because it's ultimate team of the season. I had my eyes on the prize. I want to give myself the best chance of getting that Ronaldo, that Mbappe, that Neymar, that Ben Yedder. I want that on my team. It's going to be pretty much the last weekend league I take serious. And I did. I kept my mind on doing the important things right. In previous weekend leagues, I wasn't defending well. I was overcommitting. So this weekend, I really focused on keeping the shape. Not over committing, making sure that I blocked the passing lanes, blocked the attacker's route to the goal rather than tackling right away. This game does not really reward you if you tackle. So I've just noticed that jockeying and playing positional defense is a lot better. I've been doing a lot better with that. On the offensive side, I've been just making sure I make smart passes, I try not to lose it in the wrong place. And I played possession. I didn't play 4-triple-2. I just found my players were too far apart. I was playing possession. I played patient, and it paid off. We finished 20-9 this weekend league, our best weekend league in a while. And I felt like I controlled most of the games I played. The games I did lose were very close, except that one loss you saw me take on stream where I lost 5-0. But other than that, I played a very good weekend league. I'm very happy with this. And I'm taking next weekend league off, so I'm glad that we finished it off on a bang. 20-9. We're hoping for good weekend league rewards. And yeah, that's going to be the episode for today. Let me know in the comment section down below how your weekend league went. Once again, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll see you guys in the next episode. But until then, later.